So I just actually got off of the most amazing Jumpstart client session. I always get so excited when I start working with new clients, but I also get excited, I think just as excited for weight gain cases as I do for weight loss cases, because we still need to do the right things in order to gain weight, gain healthy weight, gain muscle, heal hormones, balance digestion, all that good stuff. So anyways, but one of the questions that came in on the Q&A that I posted the other day was about my thoughts on counting macros for carnivore. Do I think that it's more effective to count them, not to count them? There's so much, you know, do count, don't count, you don't need to count, like all of that stuff out there. So that being said, as far as macros go, my approach is that if it works for you to count them, then count them. And if it's a trigger for you to count them, then don't count them. So one of the reasons that I actually developed the macro formula that I use in my practice with my clients is because of all of the crappy macro formulas that are out there. Yes, I said it. There's tons of crappy macro formulas out there. Really, you know, making really low recommendations for women who want to rebalance their hormones, rebalance their gut, and lose weight. So anyways, I could get on that soapbox forever and I'm not going to. So again, the approach should always be getting to intuitive eating, making sure that you're eating enough on a daily basis. That's both protein and fat. If you are eating some carbohydrates, make sure that you're getting the right balance for whatever you have going on with insulin resistance and, you know, rebalancing hormones, digestion, like I talked about, and always whatever works for you. So if it's counting, then count. And if it's not counting, then